I'm Mark Wright with Felice Farms in Hollister, California.
Hi, my name is Patrick Fantra. I'm Vice President of F&S Farms in Hollister, California and Cantua Creek, California.
Yes, my name is Enrique Martinez. I'm the farm manager here at Donald Valprado Farms in southern Bakersfield, southern end of the San Joaquin Valley.
My name is John Calandry. I farm in the Lancaster area as well as the Coachella Valley.
I'm Rob Guerra with Santa Barbara Farms in Lompoc, California. We farm produce here, a couple of thousand acres.
I'm Larry Ott with Gila Valley Farms. We farm in Yuma, Arizona. We farm about 5,000 acres of vegetables, and all that ground is double cropped with a summer crop of either cotton, wheat, sedan.
My name's Steve Alameda. I'm with Top Flavor Farms, and I manage our farm in the Yuma area. We farm a couple thousand acres down here of produce, and then we'll put an alfalfa crop like this in for rotation.
We purchased a Lemonator about a year ago, and our biggest fear was the cost, the sticker shock. But Empire Machinery was very patient with letting us demo the machine, and we demoed it for, probably a week and a half, 2 weeks on different types of soil. And we were able to tell right away that it was going to save us a lot of money in tillage.
And we bought our Lemonator in 2010. We use it daily from about March all the way through November.
And we started using Wilcox products about 15 years ago.
And, Tim from Kern Machinery brought the Lemonator out with Alan for us to trial. And, after several passes, we saw the potential in our ground preparation for our vegetable crops. Soon after that, we purchased the Lemonator and we've been very happy with it.
I have purchased several pieces of Wilcox equipment over the years. Finish chisel, rippers, eliminators. This is my second eliminator. But today I want to talk about the eliminator. Alan, who is a typical salesman in full bull, told me if I bought an eliminator, I would never have to land plane again or never have to disc again. Well, once I got over this lie, I said, well, let's buy one and bring it up and let's see what it'll do. So the very first season I had this, I land planed some fields and I did some fields with just the eliminator. It happened to be a very rainy year. After the rain subsided and I went to all my ranches, I noticed that everywhere that I had land planed, I had puddles. And in the fields that I had eliminated, they were perfectly level and the water had entered into the ground unbelievably uniformly. I was amazed. At that point, I parked my land planes, which was probably 8 years ago, and I've never land planed a piece of onion ground ever again.
This is our eliminator, the one that we own that takes care of this whole ranch that we have. We only own one and it's able to keep up with 10-hour days and stuff. It's all, the tractor's all GPS run. We bought this Wilcox and the GPS system and the tractor pulls it from Quinn in Santa Maria, and they've really helped us out a lot. But the way this thing's designed with these discs in front, these things just cut right through those big clods on the plowed ground. And out here, as you can see, this is a ripped ground that was ripped at probably 36 inches deep. This is one pass with the Wilcox. A few clods that the ripper pulls up, but with these discs, they just go through it, cut it all up, come back with these ripper shanks. More not really a ripper, but like a really deep chisel. We're probably going approximately 16 inches, 14 to 16 with these chisels that loosen it all back up. And then this roller, the way this roller is designed, it comes in and seems like the more horsepower you have, the faster you go, this thing just works the soil all back up, fluffs it all back up, puts all the stuff back up on top in case you buried any of the clods, then comes back and it does it again. It comes through, rips it up. The chisels are staggered with the front, so they're not in the same position, same amount of depth, probably 16 inches, 14, 16 or something like that. Then it lifts it back up and then you come back with the roller again, same type of roller, like fluffs it all back up, and then they designed this other roller that kind of pushes the clods back in on top, settles them all down, and then here comes with the roller back here. And this roller here could be set different tensions, different weight that you want on it with the wheels and everything. So the adjustment, once you get, you have to adjust everything, the rollers, the chisels, everything, you get it all adjusted. It takes some time, but once you get it set, you just leave everything alone and go from field to field with it. It's pretty simple after that.
We first evaluated the cost of the machine. You know, we looked at all the components and all the applications it was doing at one time, and we felt that, you know, to buy a disc and a ripper and a chisel and a roller and everything this one unit is doing, you still got more bang for your buck buying this unit and as one complete one complete unit and doing one pass over the ground. Over time, we found, you know, in our ground, in our area, is typically heavy, dark soil. You know, we were doing anywhere from 10 to, you know, 14 or 15 passes. In the summertime, when we're turning ground, we've cut that back down to somewhere around, you know, 5 to 7 passes in the middle of the year. So it's been a huge benefit to our program.
Soil conditions, we have from very sandy soil to very heavy gummy soil on our ranch, and it's easy to adjust to the various soil conditions and for what we need to grow a better crop.
The thing that impressed us most when we first demoed the eliminator was that we could go on right behind the lettuce beds, behind the harvest machines, and in one pass we had our beds down flat, level, and ready to plant.
What we have found with Wilcox implements is they're almost indestructible. You pay for it, and Alan will remind you that you're getting every penny that you're spending worth out of the equipment, but we've just found that it's by far the best product on the market today. And when he finally gets that tape removal thing dialed in, I'm sure we'll probably have one of those also.
We go back a long ways with Wilcox implement and Alan Wilcox. Wilcox has always given us things that would work with the implements that we had, and with the tractors, the equipment that we had. I have a ripper here that I have. I know it's got at least 20 years on it. The frame is still straight. It still has the original shanks that went on it. The gauge wheels are all nice and straight, and you see how those things were engineered. When we bought it at the time, that ripper was probably 20% more than any other ripper that was on the market. And to swallow that was kind of a tough pill. I still have that ripper. It still had any other ripper, you know, we would have pulled the gauge wheels off of it by now. So those are the things that you, as farmers, you see that, you know, they come back to you. Those investments come back. And we're looking that this eliminator will be the same way. Not only will it's built to last and run, but it's also built to save us money while it's running.
Not only are growers involved with sticker shock when they pick up a piece of this equipment, but they're worried about maintenance. We've had almost no problems at all with this machine since we've owned it. This particular machine, I believe, is about 5 years old, and we just recently put on our first set of rotors on the front, and on the back, we're still running on the original rotors. We've been in rocky conditions. We've never broken a rotor. I personally cannot think of any part on this piece of equipment that we have broken since it was delivered. Just an amazing, amazing piece of equipment when it comes to maintenance. And with the new hydraulic ones, which this is, much easier to set and much easier to move from ranch to ranch. One of the problems with conventional tillage is that we're in the field lots of times, burning lots of fuel in a lot of compaction. We've probably cut our passes through the field by 60% by using the eliminator. That is huge, not to mention the cost, but not destroying the carbon in the soil that's so greatly needed. And if nothing else, that benefit alone is invaluable. We, with the less trips through the field, less dust, less fuel. It's just an easier life for me with the eliminator.
when we first saw the size and the magnitude of this piece of equipment, and we were a little shocked at first when we saw the, you know, with the price tag on it, we said, hey, maybe this isn't for us. But the rep from Quinn came out, and Alan came out personally when it came and set it up and did a demonstration. And it was, you know, he was hands-on, you know, the guy right from the company. And we actually demoed the unit for 900 acres before we bought it. But truth be known, we knew we were going to probably buy it the first hour we saw it work.
My new Wilcox Ripper that I just purchased. This is probably the fourth generation. I bought it, the first generation back in 2000, and it's served me very well. And then now it's time to buy this the new generation. And as you can see, it's very well built. So we run the Ripper first, and then we come back in with the Eliminator to make a very nice seed bed, so we can grow our vegetable crops. And it saves the Eliminator. Before, we used to have to disc 2-3 times. Now we just run the Eliminator behind the Ripper, and we're ready to make a nice seed bed.
It's pretty simple to figure out how you're gonna pay for it when you figure out how many passes it's gonna save you. Because on conventional land prep, behind vegetables, we would disc a minimum of 2 to 4 times, depending on the soil type. And with the Eliminator, we were able to eliminate at least one pass. We can, in many cases, we can run the Eliminator one pass and sometimes two passes, and we could plant our wheat directly behind the Eliminator. And then in many cases, just one pass and we're ready for the laser, where historically we'd go at least 3 passes with a conventional disc. And so in trying to justify the cost of it, it's not what it costs, it's what it's gonna save you. And if you take what it costs you to run a conventional disc, which is a round figure of about $25 to $27 an acre, and we start adding up all the passes that we were going to save and what that was costing us and what the savings would be, and we basically paid for our Eliminator in one season between our summer tillage behind our summer crops and doing our tillage behind our vegetables to plant our wheat or our Sudan.
The job, and it isn't necessarily the acreage you cover, it's the work that's being done as it goes. This is equivalent of a ripper, a disc, another ripper, another disc, a ring rolling. This all goes in, and while it's moving along, it's carrying a volume of dirt with it that's leveling as it goes. So it's doing all these applications as it's going. I figure I'm getting 3 for 1 and maybe 4 for 1 when this thing's running. So if you take the 25 gallons of fuel an hour it's running, but reducing the passes that it's doing, it's saving money. Like I say, I've had good luck with Wilcox implements in the past, and I don't see any reason for that to change right now. But you can see as it's built, the size of the tires and the quality of the hydraulic cylinders and the shields on the ripper shanks and the things that are built into this thing, it's just made to last, well built and made to last and made to be able to maintain so it will last. Anyway.